Blackstone Publishing presents Innocent Bystander by Craig Rice. This book is read by Malcolm Hillgartner. Chapter 1. Alibis While You Wait. The pier is still there, of course. So are its people. They will always be there. Oh, sure, this pier will be torn down someday, but another one will be built in its place. Yes, Ferris wheel and all. The people? Well, some of them are dead now. Murdered, in case anyone should ask you. And some of them have just moved on. Atlantic City, Coney Island, Long Beach, Riverside Park, and small town carnivals. But there will always be others to take their places. Yes, even the places of the ones who were murdered. You've seen the pier. You've been there. Remember? The street leading up to it is bordered with hot dog stands, popcorn parlors, all-night restaurants, delicatessens, and fortune tellers. There's a world-famous ballroom and a couple of movie theaters. There's the biggest bowling alley in the world. The street itself is littered with old newspapers, empty peanut shells, odds and ends of cigarette packages, and just plain trash. But the pier, once you've turned the corner leading into it, is a child's dream of paradise. Lights, music, rides, concessions where, for a 90-cent investment, you can win a 10-cent plaster doll and go home happy. You can have your wait guest, be told the state you were born in, see a bandit car riddled with bullets, ride the roller coaster, eat hot dogs, french fries, taffy apples, and soft ice cream cones, drink root beer, soda pop, and orange juice. You can go through the funhouse, drive 6 nails for a dime, play skee-ball, 12 shots for a nickel, and go down in the diving bell, 30 feet under the surface of the ocean, to be scared by a man-eating shark who leers at you through the porthole. You can pick up a date, get into a fight, or both. Or you can ride the big Ferris wheel. You see it the minute you turn onto the pier, dominating the whole scene. A double wheel, blazing with lights that turn into great fiery serpents when the wheel really starts moving fast. Sounds go along with it. The voices of the crowd, the noise of machinery turning, the music from the Wurlitzer organ on the merry-go-round, the siren from the crime does not pay concession. On this particular night, everything was just as usual, like any other jam-packed Saturday night. The lights, the sounds, the smells, the bored voices of the barkers. Just as usual, except for one detail, not yet known to the general public. One of the passengers on the big Ferris wheel was dead. Murdered. Amby, the artist, was doing one of his 50-cent crayon portraits just across the walk from the big wheel. He was sketching the face of a brown-haired girl who was perched on his high stool. Amby was a little drunk. Amby was always a little drunk. Never much more, nor much less. He never became belligerent, amorous, tearful, sentimental, or stupefied. On the other hand, he never became sober. He lived permanently in a vague and rather pleasant daze. When he woke in the morning in the huddle of dirty blankets back of his canvas booth, he automatically felt for the bottle he had tucked within easy reaching distance the night before. When he settled down to sleep at night, he took one last swig and sighed his way into mildly drunken and happy dreams. He was known only as Amby. Many years before, he had had a longer and more dignified name, but he had forgotten it long since. He wasn't quite sure who he was or where he'd come from or how he'd landed as a sketch artist on the pier, and he didn't particularly care. Sketching, he was hardly aware of his surroundings. The flashing lights from the big wheel didn't divert his attention from the girl sitting on the high stool in front of him. He reached for a brown crayon, a blue crayon, a pink crayon. The laughter from the funhouse, the rumble of the roller coaster, and screams from its...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.